Hey everybody, Tim Wang, clinical specialist here today doing another video with our patient Leticia, who has just reached her last visit. We're doing our DC session today, so she has been kind enough to talk to us about her Aspen experience, her breast implant journey regarding contracture, multiple surgeries, and all kinds of other things. So Leticia, thank you for being here, and are you glad it's over?
I am. I'm delighted to be here, so thank you for that. And I'm delighted for the solutions that you have helped me with. It's been a great experience overall. It's been very helpful and pain-free.
Fantastic.
Which is most important to me.
That's what we want. Pain, firmness, asymmetry, we don't look the same. These are all capsule-related issues that are basically, bottom line, a shell of scar tissue that forms around a breast implant. It happens in pacemakers. It happens in other procedures. It happens in orthopedic. So we want to do something non-surgical, safe, effective, cost-effective, and you chose to do the Aspen treatment because you have arguably one of the most well-known plastic surgeons in the world here in Miami. And despite his reputation and ability to be a great surgeon, encapsulated anyway, because you have had four total procedures to date, essentially.
Yes.
With the same surgeon, right? You had your original procedure 2000, you had your breast augmentation. After that, you developed a contracture on your left breast. That contracture was then followed by a third procedure by which your surgeon then did a capsulectomy where he removed the capsule tissue. You then had a problem after that in which the implant itself bottomed out. You had a revision, you had the mesh put in, and then you contracted on both of your breasts after. And that was your last surgery that you had. And then you reached out to us, you found us online, and we basically rendered the treatment to you. And now today we did our assessment. So objectively, in your, you know, evaluation, if you had to grade the softness of both breasts from 0 to 100%, what would you give it?
I would say they are both 100%. I cannot describe the softness. My one breast was much harder than the other one. Mm-hmm. The other one was hard, but not as hard. It was like a bowling ball. Mm-hmm. And they are now soft and pliable.
Perfect.
Natural feeling. They move differently as well. They're not like hard bumps in there. So yes, the softness is quite natural.
Perfect. And we'll see in the picture here, the before and after, but the asymmetry that you had where one breast was higher than the other. When you look in the mirror now, or if you're in a bra or bikini, how would you describe on a 0 to 100% scale symmetry, how they look now as you look at yourself?
The symmetry is almost perfect. I have some softness in the bottom where I had the bottoming out, mm-hmm. which has nothing to do with the contracture. But I would say, like, unless I'm looking, they look completely normal.
Perfect.
If I'm wearing clothes, a bathing suit, you can't tell. Absolutely.
Beautiful.
They're normal.
That's what we're looking for. And although there is an objective measure to what we do, the most important thing is your subjective report, right? Because I tell everybody, it's kind of like we're hairdressers in medical lab coats. No matter how great I cut your hair, it's honestly how you want to look, right? So that is why each patient is individually evaluated. We set a specific plan of care based on your individual goals. We are not a technical center. We do not just throw machines on people like medi spas and aesthetic places, and everybody gets the same treatment. Every patient is evaluated, given a specific plan of care. You're seen by licensed specialists, so we are able to get where you are today, which is soft, looks great, any residual pain resolved, and that's why we're chatting with other women out there. So one of the interesting things with your procedure is that you had the mesh put into the left side. So let's talk about the mesh a little bit. The mesh, what they call ADM, acellular dermal matrix, there's numerous companies that produce this. I won't mention the name of them. But anytime you hear the word mesh or skin or anything added to it, the issue with those is it's the surgeon's quandary to create stability, but the also side effect is they claim it reduces capsular contracture.
Right.
The problem is that claim is not true, because claims of that with products or medical stuff is that there has to be an FDA approval associated with that. There's not a single mesh out there right now that is FDA approved for the indication of capsular contracture, and you were told that it reduces the rate of contracture. Correct. Well, not only is that not fair and right for somebody to tell you that a mesh reduces capsular contracture, it has no FDA approval to support that. And more importantly, you are a victim of the disinformation that you were told it would, because you encapsulated anyway.
Mm-hmm.
And then on top of that, you had your left breast, which was the original issue, and then you went into surgery, and now, dun dun dun, the right breast contracts on top of that. So that's a real important point that anybody out there, you know, considering surgery, even if you got the surgery for free, you're at a very, very high risk for recontracting, no matter how great the surgeon is, no matter the surgical technique that's touted, or the skin strip, or the mesh, or the I do this, or the no touch, or the funnels and all this. There is always that risk, because we, the human, are the lowest common denominator, and it is our immune systems and how they react to the foreign body in conjunction to bacteria and other triggers and immune system issues that dictate how we get there. And again, the lowest common denominator of this is you had arguably one of the most notable, reputable surgeons. You had multiple surgeries. You had the mesh. You still contract it anyway. So what do we do about it? We want to do something non-surgical at all costs. I don't care if you do 10 cartwheels, you know, do the alphabet backwards, Z to A, and you get it perfectly and you have a magic potion. Do that first before you even consider surgery, because the risk is statistically 70 to 90% on the first surgery, 90% or more on the second surgery. And then if you're getting into the category of third surgery or above, you're in the kind of the no man's land. Most surgeons won't even really touch you at that point. And then they start talking about explantation. Well, we'll just take the implants out, and then you'll produce a whole nother set of complications where you will have major scars, lift skin tissue resection, you may develop fibrosis in the chest, lumps and knots. So on top of being flat, not looking the way you may want to have looked to begin with, you may then get intractable pain, you may get lumps that we call fibrosis. The nerve endings grow into those lumps, and then they hurt. And then you come back to our center afterwards, because now we have to treat you for post-end block or explant fibrosis, other soft tissue disorders. So it's really important. Anybody thinking about removing your implants, taking them out, you're frustrated with your capsule history, you're doing an end block. There are very specific indications for women that they should remove their implants. That is BII, breast implant illness. That is an indication where we absolutely must get that implant out. But if you're frustrated with your capsule, definitely consider all non-surgical options first prior to going there. So then we can get to where we are with you today, which is treated, non-surgical, done. We don't have to worry about this ever again. We instruct you on things on how to prevent the capsule from coming back. And of course, we're always available where if, God forbid, in 5 or 10 years, we trigger a new capsule, which we can do with pregnancy, breastfeeding, trauma, undiagnosed autoimmune disorders. You know, hey, Tim, you know, I did the aspirin treatment 10 years ago with you guys, and it got hard again. I think the treatment wore off. The treatment didn't wear off. There's probably a new trigger that started that. But the good news is, assuming it's not a surgical issue, we can always do touch-up treatments to be able to knock this out and get to where you were. One of the other things with you was originally there was some pain that you were having in the left chest. Now that the treatment is resolved, that has been significantly reduced and will most likely completely resolve now that the treatment's over and we're not massaging and, you know, doing all this soft tissue work to you. But you felt an improvement with the discomfort.
The discomfort from the type of discomfort that I had is completely gone. And actually, it's really interesting. After the first treatment, on the drive home, I felt relief. Although I felt sore from the treatment here, it was discomfort and not the pain I'd had. And I progressively, with each treatment, got slightly better from a pain perspective. What I am now is just sore from the treatment. But it's different. So I would say from what brought
me
here.
It's tough to work breast tissue. You know, it's not like we're massaging your back and it feels great. It is very tough for us to manipulate breast tissue. I personally don't know. I don't have breasts, but I can imagine, after years of doing this, tissue like a breast tissue, being as sensitive as it is, would and is, because we see this all the time, if we have to very aggressively treat a advanced capsule, you're manipulating that tissue, so there is a byproduct of it. But once the treatment is done and now you're in the do nothing stage, you're graduating, we don't need to do any more massages or any more of the treatment, our patients normally report that that pain resolves and it goes away. Right. And I won't even use pain. I don't think
it's a discomfort.
It's
a discomfort. It's a soreness.
It is. Your condition, interestingly, is very similar in the medical community to a condition called adhesive capsulitis. Adhesive capsulitis is frozen shoulder. So women, traditionally women, some men, women who have the same triggers, a rotator cuff surgery, a autoimmune issue, a diabetes, thyroid dysfunction will spontaneously, their shoulder will freeze and they you know, they can't brush their hair, they can't put their bra on. And I think you described it as you've seen a friend with that, you know, T-Rex.
She has little T-Rex arms.
Right,
is
so because her shoulder is frozen, it's the exact same phenomenon. The shell that covers the ball and socket of the shoulder has literally contracted in an autoimmune response, which is the original basis for how I developed the treatment protocol for this treatment. The technology and the treatment protocol was based on frozen shoulder, which is why we hypothesized its effectiveness and that it works, because we're manipulating that capsule and opening up. And one of the first things that happens when we treat patients with frozen shoulder is they've been months frozen, they're in pain, it's even worse at night because they're not moving, a little better during the day, and then the first time we take and we start mobilizing that capsule, we start stretching the arm, they hate us in the moment, but it's the first night that they've slept in maybe 3 to 9 months.
Right.
Because once you release the tightness of the contracture, then you will feel a relief, although we are beating up your breast a little bit, treatment-wise. And it was horrible. Everybody watching was like, oh my God, they beat up your breast. It's not really that bad.
Right.
But we do need to aggressively manipulate that tissue. But again, the same thing where we manipulate a frozen shoulder, we manipulate a breast capsule because we want to safely prescribe a treatment. Surgery has such a high failure rate because all you're doing is waking up the autoimmune dragon and you're just chancing the same result over and over again. When we do a therapeutic protocol like a non-surgical aspirin treatment program, our autoimmune system is happy with that. It says, I'm okay with you stretching. I'm okay with you ultrasounding. I'll let this capsule stretch out. I will let the implant drop. The pain then resolves because the immune system says, hey, whatever you're doing, we're okay with that. The second the surgeon takes a scalpel and makes that first cut and opens you up, the immune system, what I call the you know, sleeping dragon, gets woken up and, you know, here comes fire and brimstone and you're right back to where you were. So moving forward, graduating, everything looks good. You should not have a problem with this. You now know what to do moving forward to be able to do it. I want to ask you one question. If I was your surgeon and I said, I will do the surgery for free. Matter of fact, I'm not only going to do the surgery for you, but here's some tickets to movies and a nice night out on the town on me. I'm the surgeon. Knowing what you know now, even if you had the surgery for free, would you risk doing surgery or would you go the route of a non-surgical option that you had to put some time and money into?
No, I would not repeat it. After doing the research that I did myself to find the Aspen Center, speaking to you and the results, because remember, I'm four surgeries in.
Yep.
Right?
Yep.
I would not do it.
It's three surgeries too many.
Yeah. So I definitely would not do it. Right. This, I think, has given me results, you know, that are fantastic. I've had no downtime, although you do have to be committed to the protocol, right? You have to be a good student and do your homework. But it's easy. It's not like the recovery from the surgeries that I've had that have been costly and painful, only to end up there again. So I highly recommend that people do their homework and look for alternative options.
Absolutely. You mentioned a very important thing, which is compliance. So, you know, the dispelling myths, our treatment is not you come in and there's a magic machine that we wave our magic machine wand around and poof, the problem goes away. It is a compliance thing. So patients, besides our proprietary technology, besides our techniques, our hands-on, the education, there is a home program of compliance that we educate you to be able to do at home. So if patients are not doing their home program, they're only going to get a minimal result with treatment here. But despite that, still, no surgery, no risk, no infection, no hematoma, no seroma, no downtime. You know, you have surgery, then you're out of work for how long? It's way easier to do a non-surgical option and work around your work schedule versus, hey, I'm going to be out of work for 2 weeks and recovering, and then follow up. And statistically, our research has consistently supported, and anybody who has any question regarding this, we'd be happy to provide you with the links regarding our actual research and supporting medical documentation, as well as top plastic surgeons from all over the world who support our system, use our system, key opinion leaders, you know, everybody in the medical community, in which we can provide you with the actual data and research supporting what we're doing. Although we love testimonials, the reality is we need to look at this as a scientific basis. And everybody here that renders treatment is a licensed medical clinician of the highest level of certification, trained specifically in the Aspen treatment to be able to do this. So final note is, if you're watching this and seeking this, please do not seek out massage therapists, chiropractors, medi spas, people who claim that they use ultrasound machines, ultrasound devices, cavitation machines, all kinds of other, you know, X-wave machines and microneedling machines. These are not approved treatments, and actually some of those machines can actually harm you, burn you, denature the protein layer around the capsule, and make your contracture worse. So know that you're dealing with the developers of the treatment. We hold a U.S. patent on this treatment. We have research to support it. So be careful in who you seek, which leads us to our last thing. You live near us. Well, kind of near us, right? You drive to us to be able to get treatment, but there's folks out there watching right now who do not live near us, and they say, I want treatment, where do I get it, how do I get it? First step is always virtual evaluation. We can see you from anywhere in the world, assuming there's not a major time change. No, I will not wake up in the morning at 4 a.m. to do a virtual with you, but if you're flexible with your time, we do a virtual with a clinical expert who looks at you, evaluates you, gets your history, and from there we can tell you, where do you get the treatment, how do you get the treatment, what's the cost of the treatment going to be. We do this for breast implant contracture. We do it for patients who have liposuction fibrosis, facelift complications, all kinds of soft tissue disorders in every aspect of plastic surgery, really. So do the virtual, get some information, at least get a second opinion, right? Because you were in a position where you had to rely solely on your surgeon for 100% of your solution. And your solution three times, your only solution offered to you was surgery. And you had a problem multiple times despite surgery. So can you imagine having arguably one of the best, most reputable surgeons around, does not provide you with the information? This surgeon, by the way, how are you, doc? This surgeon, by the way, who I respect greatly, has used our services for many, many years. They're just down the road in the other county. Has used our services for many, many years, knows about us. There's no excuse why you shouldn't have been referred for treatment, but yet you had to find us on your own. So how frustrating.
It's disappointing.
Yeah.
Because for me, it's one of the, arguably one of the most well-respected surgeons, so I can only imagine others. And I completely found you just out of curiosity that perhaps there is something else, something non-surgical for me to explore. And perhaps, you know, some people aren't, you know, as skilled as being able to find it. And I saw your technology is licensed, you know, and so I started digging. And you know, I decided to come up here. It was well worth the drive for me.
Right, which is why we appreciate this. So to be able to have an honest testimonial, and I didn't pay you.
Nope.
I didn't give you any incentives.
Nope.
I made you sit around and wait after your assessment. and I said, please give me your time, do a testimonial.
Yeah. No, it's completely unpaid. I'm not an influencer. I'm a patient.
Right. real patients, yeah. real results, Aspen rehabilitation. So no, but this is the important part, is that the ability to get two patients, give them real information from real patients who have had that treatment, to be able to offset the community of information, is super important. So thank you.
Thank you.
And congrats to you.
Thank you. Thank you. I think it's important because I mentioned the home compliance and the diligence, just for perspective. It's not something that takes hours. It's 15, 20 minutes, right? It's important. It's not like it's a overwhelming commitment, and it's so worth it.
We
it's
start
so
off with backflips. We then count
downward
alphabet
dog,
Z, Z to A. We do some chants. There's some smoke, right? There's incense. There's candles, right? We burn our sage. I give you guys a statue, an Aspen statue. You go home. I think it's six prayers within 8 minutes, right?
And a couple of chants.
I mean, that's not really a big deal. That's pretty simple in my mind. But no,
it's worth it. Thank you.
It is. If we were trying to lose weight, our personal trainer would instruct us, but we would have to do the workout, right? If we were trying to lose weight and our dietitian said, here's what you do, but you have to go home and you have to follow the diet plan, right? If I was your doctor and you had diabetes, you have to go home and follow the diet and take the medication or the insulin, and that is the nature of it. That's the reality why our program is as successful as it is, because we have no risk, we have nothing but benefit, and it puts you in the control seat of being able to take a part in your own care. So, you know, any questions, take a look at the banner below. We've got the 877 number. Call us, email us, go online, take a look at our Instagram, take a look at, you know, other videos on YouTube of other patients similar to you, to be able to kind of see, get some information, connect with us, so we could possibly do a after video with you just like this with Leticia to be able to say, we're glad you did great results. So again,
thank you so much.
Congrats again.
Thank you.
You're welcome.